news here. If you suffer from migraine headaches, Botox, which is better known for eliminating facial wrinkles, can actually help reduce or eliminate migraine pain. So joining us today is Dr. Adam Weinfeld from the Seton Institute of Reconstructive Plastic Surgery and one of his patients, Julie Kirk, to help explain. Thanks so much for being with us today, guys.
Thanks for having us.
Start with talking about the process of Botox and kind of what it involves.
Well, Botox is a neuromodulator. It's a medication that when injected into muscles can weaken the signals that go to the muscles and thus weaken the contraction of the muscles. So the way that it works in migraine patients is when it's injected in the muscles that wrap around the nerves that come out to the face and give sensation to the face and to the scalp and the areas in the head, it weakens the muscle contractions around those nerves and decreases the irritation of those nerves. It's thought that in many migraine patients, or migraineurs as they're known, the contraction of those muscles and the irritation of those sensory nerves is what may cause their migraine headaches.
And you say this is something that's well established. When did doctors start to realize this side effect, I guess?
About 7 to 10 years ago, it started to be noticed.
And Julie, describe to us kind of the pain you were feeling beforehand compared to what it is now.
Well, I had headaches starting as a teenager, and then over the years they got worse and worse, and I started trying different preventative medications, and it seemed like they would work for maybe a couple of weeks, and then they would stop working. So one of the ER doctors I work with recommended that I see Dr. Weinfeld and see if Botox was right for me. And last year in July, I got my first series of injections, and I didn't have a migraine for 5 weeks. And I had probably never gone 5 weeks without a migraine since I was 12 years old. So it was the best 5 weeks ever.
Yeah, why?
The headaches were really debilitating. Usually vomiting and photosensitivity would make me miss work and really just so much pain. You have to go to a dark room. And now I can feel myself, I can feel a headache coming on, but it's like it won't ball up and turn into a full-fledged migraine. Even if I have a twinge of a headache, it doesn't turn into a migraine. I haven't had a full-fledged migraine with vomiting since July of last year.
And that was just after
one series,
right?
Well, I've had multiple. We re-injected in November and then just recently in March. So 3 series, but it's just amazing. It's changed my life.
Incredible. And so, and one of the issues was now Botox is covered by some insurance companies?
That's true. There have been some changes recently that because of the experience that has been noted over the past several years. And so, and carriers are recognizing that that it's less expensive actually to pay for Botox than to pay for all the prophylactic and medications and the medications that people take when they're, in the extremes of a migraine, and certainly less expensive than paying for an emergency room visit. So they have come around and started to cover this.
And then how often or repeated are the treatments?
Well, it all depends on the patient, but for most patients, the cycle is every 3 months, because that's about the duration of the Botox. Some people need it a little bit more frequently, some people need it less frequently.
Oh, look great and feel great. It's quite a case right there. Dr. Weinfeld, Julie, thanks for being with us this morning.
Thanks for having us.